Sir, I always see that I have to go to the front and back. I have tried all of them for that, but I am not yet. So what is the reason and how I can go to the front?
Sir, name?
Ajay Deep Singh.
Ajay Deep is asking, sir. Ajay Deep is asking, how can I overcome my bad habits? How can I overcome my bad habits? Right? How do you know whether a particular habit is good or bad? How do you decide?
You have been told in advance, right?
Yes.
You have been told in advance what is good and what is bad. That is the way we go about deciding everything, what is right, what is wrong, what is fair, what is unfair, on the basis of criteria that have been given to us in advance, that have been told to us beforehand, that this is good, this is bad. Once you know, really, really know, what is harmful to you, what will cause suffering to you, will you still go ahead and do it? Once you can see the entire cause-effect chain, not just believe in somebody's words, not just believe that my parents have told me or society has told me or religion has told me, so something has to be bad. My religion, for example, tells me that eating non-vegetarian stuff, eating animal flesh, meat, is bad. And I may happen to be a Jain. So for me, meat is bad. But do I really know for myself what is meat and what is meant by meat consumption? Do I really understand? Do I really understand? I don't understand. I may still not eat meat, but that abstinence from eating meat is purely a habit given by somebody else, right? But this eating meat, amusingly, this abstinence you will call as a good habit, right? And hence you have created two words, good habits and bad habits. I want to ask you a question. Is there anything called a good habit? Is there anything called a good habit? Of course, the answer is yes, because that's the way we believe, right? That there are certain good habits. What is a habit by definition? What is the definition of a habit? What is the definition of a habit? Have you ever tried to understand? What is the definition of a habit? Which you do daily. But whatever you do daily, is that a habit?
Will you call it a habit?
We do this frequently.
Yes, but is merely the act of doing a habit, or is a habit something else? Interest. Does a habit depend on interest? If it is really your interest, why would you want to get rid of a habit? And if it is your interest, do you need a habit? Out of interest you will do it. Why do you need a habit? Interest is sufficient. What is a habit? You are right. Some of you have said that which we do continuously in a routine, frequently, is a habit. This is a good point to start, but this definition is not complete. Something is missing in this definition. What is missing in this definition? Wonderful. Very good. So, a habit means two things. One, there is a pattern. We do it regularly. Second, we do it without understanding. We do it without being conscious. We are not really aware that this is happening. It just happens because of habit. And somebody will ask you, why did you do this? And you will say, oh, it's a habit with me. Right? That's a habit. There is no utilization of the mind. You don't even think. It just happens. Like in a machine. A button is pressed and the system starts operating. Without understanding why it is operating that way. Right? That's a habit. What is a habit? We said two things. Tell me, what is a habit? One. First thing, that it is done. Very good. Very good. And second thing, it is done without being aware. In the moments when the habit is functioning, we do not even know what we are doing. Later on, we may recall, we may repent, we may feel bad. But when the habit is acting, at that moment, we have no awareness and hence no power. You are powerless, right? In front of the habit, you are totally powerless. Is that so? Yes? There is a force of the habit. And that force is of the pattern of the habit. Am I right? Now tell me, how can there be good habits and bad habits? How can there be good habits and bad habits? We just took an example, if I am a Jain, then for me, not eating meat is a, which kind of habit?
Bad.
Not eating meat.
Good habit.
For a Jain, not eating meat is a good habit. For people of some other religions, killing animals on the occasions of certain festivals is again a habit. Because it is being done every year after year, continuously. But they will say that killing is a? The Jain will say killing is a? Strange. Same act. The Jain will say that killing is a? Meat eating. Is meat eating not a habit?
We will investigate.
Will a Jain see? We said a habit is something that you do without understanding, right? Will a Jain not eat meat had he been born in some other family? It's not a question of interest. It's a question of understanding. Interest and understanding are two different things. Very, very different things.
Like the killing of animals
Do they understand?
Awareness is not that I know that I am holding this mic. Awareness is something totally different. Awareness is understanding. Do I really understand why I am not eating meat? Or do I really understand why I am killing the animal? I am born in a particular religion or in a particular caste. So, since childhood, I was told that meat eating is bad. I was born in a particular religion or in a particular part of the world or in a particular caste. So, what was I told since childhood? That meat eating is bad. So, I'm not eating meat. But do I really understand what is meat eating? Do I really understand what is meant by killing? That is habit. That which you do and regularly do but without understanding. What's your name? Do you understand, Sakshi? Whatever we do but don't understand is a
habit.
Whatever we do but don't understand is a habit. Now, can there be good habits? Can there be good habits at all? Because if you say something is a good habit, then you are saying that not understanding is good. Because a habit by definition means I don't understand, but I do. I don't understand, but I do. Now, can anything be a good habit? Can anything be a good habit? So, let this come to you very, very clearly, very strongly, that no habit is a good habit. No habit is a good habit. Habit, by definition, means that I am doing it just because of conditioning, just because I am habituated. Just because there is a pattern from the past that I am following. Just because there is a pattern from the past that I am following. The question then arises, why do we call it a good habit? And we address that first thing in the morning. Because we have been told that certain things are good and certain things are bad. So, we have started calling some habits as good and some habits as bad. We have started calling some habits as good and some habits as bad. But as intelligent people, we must clearly understand that the question is not, you started with that question, right? How do I get rid of my bad habits? The question is not how to get rid of bad habits, but how to get rid of, how to get rid of all habits, whether good or bad. Can you ask this question? Can all of us ask this question? How to lead a habit-free life? Is that not a more important question to ask? How to lead a life which is entirely free of habits? I don't have any habits. Whatever I do out of my understanding. I don't need habits. I am aware and every action is happening out of that awareness. Every action is happening in that awareness. I don't need habits. Habits are needed only for those who are half asleep.
So they are aware about that, but we do so. Why?
You are not really aware. Really, really aware. You are not really aware. Do you understand? Do you understand? Understand this. Do you know what is meant by being really aware? A truck is coming towards you and you are immediately sensing the danger. The entire mechanism of knowing is functioning with great sensitivity. You don't even have to think and you know, and then you will not say, oh, it is my habit to walk in middle of the road. The moment you see a truck coming, what will you do? You will jump away. Will you say that it is my habit to walk in the middle of the road? You won't have time to make such a foolish statement. That is what I mean by being really aware, to understand the urgency of the situation, to be in contact with the danger ahead, to know what it is really, really like. But there is a problem. The problem is of time. When the truck is there in front of me, just 20 meters, then I can see that within a fraction of a second it will hit me. But when I am drinking alcohol, then I cannot see that I am dying, because that dying is still many years ahead, right? The truck will hit me right now, but out of drinking alcohol I will not die right now. When will I die? When will I die? Maybe a few months, a few years, a few decades later. So I cannot be alive to the danger of what I am doing. That's the thing. To be really intelligent means to see the entire cause-effect chain in one instance. Right now. Right now I can see what will be the result of what I am doing. Time is not needed. Yes, there may be a time interval of 10 years. But those 10 years cannot deceive me. I will not be fooled by those 10 years. As I am doing this action right now, I am able to see the results right now. I don't have to wait for 10 years. I will not deceive myself. And I can see the complete repercussion in this moment itself. I will not tell myself, oh, future is so far ahead, let me enjoy it right now. That's what we tell ourselves, right? Live in the present. And by living in the present, what we say is that do what is to be done right now. And we misuse such a beautiful statement. Living in the present is such a beautiful thing to say, but we misuse it, right? What do we say? By living in the present, what we mean is being asleep in the present. That do whatever you want to do now and don't bother. Is that the meaning of living in the present? Surely not, right? I assure you, each one of you, that habits are powerless. If you really see what you are doing, and to really see what you are doing, you just need to pause for a while and pay attention. You don't need to label it as a bad habit. You know what? You all are young, and in youth, the mind is rebellious. It wants to rebel. The moment somebody tells you that something is bad, you want to do more of it. The more you will tell yourself that a particular action or habit is bad, your mind will be inclined more towards it. Am I right? Certain websites are bad. And what do? You may not visit anything else, but you will specifically watch those websites. Bad movie, go watch it. Bad magazines, go read them. Bad actions, don't bunk the class. Don't copy assignments. And you will especially do them, because bad is exciting. Bad has a thrill and adventure about it. And youth loves adventure. Let me do all the bad things first, right? So, if somebody asks you how to keep a habit permanent, the answer is, declare it to be a bad habit. The moment you declare something to be bad, it stays forever. As I was coming to your campus, there was this wall besides a place of worship. And it was written on it in the Hindi language. What do you write on walls? On places of worship? Kindly do not urinate here. And I am so sure that the entire city goes there to urinate. The moment you prohibit something, the moment you forbid something, the mind wants to do it. The mind wants to do it. Is that not the nature of the mind? The moment you forbid something, it will do it. Don't we do all those things that are forbidden? Don't we do all those things? And we feel especially good when we break a rule or a law. Don't we feel good? Yes, I displayed my masculinity. I am somebody. I did all those forbidden things. In the Abrahamic tradition, do you know how man came on earth? They say, all the three religions coming from the Abrahamic tradition, they say that God first made Adam and Eve. And then he told them not to eat. What not to eat? What not to eat? Any Muslims here? They must know. Yes? What did God forbid them to eat? The apple. And they would not have eaten the apple. One man, one woman, a large forest, an orchard, and they were very happy. Who cares for one apple? There is so much in the forest. But because God prohibited it, what did they do? Because God prohibited it, what did they do? And there was, of course, the rule of the serpent and all that. They tasted the apple, the forbidden apple. And then they say that they were expelled from heaven, from the nice forest, and they were sent to earth. And that psychology of man has not changed. It is continuing from that day till today. Habit is habit. And habit is stupidity. No habit is good habit. All habits imply that I am not living, I am just acting out of conditioning. Whenever you are in habit, you are not really alive. Do not condemn your habits out of morality. Do not say my habits are bad. Just say this is a habit. And when something is a habit, it makes you stupid. And nobody likes to be stupid, right? A habit is just stupid. A habit prevents me from living fully. A habit prevents me from acting consciously. When I understand that I don't need habit. When I don't understand, then I don't need habit. How to proceed? We said, when you really know inattention, then habit becomes powerless. Whatever small things that you do throughout the day, start paying attention to them and ask yourself, is this happening because I am aware, conscious, or is this happening because I am habituated? Let me give you an example. you walk into a classroom, and which chairs do you choose first? The ones in the front or the ones in the back? Whichever ones you choose, whether the ones in the front or in the back, ask yourself, why is it so that whenever I enter the classroom, I rush towards the back or I settle in the front? Ask yourself. Don't just do it. Pause for a second and ask yourself. That is the way to identify a habit. The moment you know it is a habit, it is gone. Then it has no more power. Are you understanding this? When you meet a teacher and you wish the teacher, just pause for a while and ask yourself, do I really feel good with this person, or is it just a habit with me to wish my seniors? If it is just a habit, it is meaningless. It is stupidity. You are just performing a ritual. Just a ritual. You meet a friend, and what do? He's a little distance away, and you wave your hand at your friend. Ask yourself, was it because of friendship and love that I waved my hand? Or is it so that it has become a habit with me, that whenever I see an acquaintance, a friend, I just wave my hand? And if it is just a habit, then pull your hand back. Come back. Stupid habit. Stupid habit. Even at this moment, ask yourself, am I really listening or are my thoughts wandering? And if your thoughts are wandering, then ask yourself, did I ask my thoughts to go here and there? Did I ask my thoughts to go there and there and there? And our thoughts are going all over the place, right? Ask yourself, did I ask my thoughts to go here and there? Or is it just a habit that whenever I sit down, my mind will start roaming? And if your mind is roaming just because it has a habit of roaming, then tell the mind, you are an idiot. And I don't want to be an idiot. So come back. Wherever you are, come back. Habit is a mechanical way of living. That's why we said that when the habit is in action, then we are not really alive. We are just like a machine. We are very much like a machine when the habit is operating. And we don't want to live like machines, do we? How many of us are interested in living like machines? Raise your hands. How many of us are interested in living like machines? And how many of us want to be fully human? How many of us want to be fully human? Yes, raise your hands. And if we want to be fully human, then we will catch the habit and not label it as a good habit or a bad habit, right? What are these good habits? I sleep at such and such time. Now, can sleeping at a particular time be always a good habit? What else are good habits? Yes, tell me. Discipline. Now, what kind of discipline is this which is coming out of habit? If right now you are attentive in listening, Sakshi, do you need discipline or you just need attention? But there will be people here who are sitting quietly just because of a discipline. Will that discipline help them? And if you are listening attentively, then do you need discipline? If we are engaged with each other right now, I am speaking to you, you are listening to me, and we are engaged with each other, do we need some discipline master to be standing here? Do we really need somebody to be standing here? We don't need anybody. Discipline is not needed. Is it needed? Only attention is needed. Whatever you call as good habit is as dead as a bad habit. This again is such a good demonstration. We had talked about it just 2 minutes back, right? The question of discipline and respect. Do I really understand what I am doing? Or is it just like, you know, there is this fan and I press that button and the fan starts operating? Does the fan understand why it's moving in such a way? Does the fan understand?
No, sir.
This is habit. Just doing it without understanding. Just doing it. You have to ask yourself, do you understand what you are doing? Really understand, it is happening. Is it happening out of your attention and understanding? Do we know respect? Do we know love? Or are we just habituated? It was a beautiful occasion to ask ourselves.